आफ्टर हैंडलिंग सैंपल, ये आपने किसको दिया है, किस हेड कांस्टेबल को दिया है, किस डेट पे दिया है, उसको आपने डॉक्यूमेंटेशन करना है। डॉक्यूमेंटेशन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सर्जन के लिए। अगर सर्जन ने कोई बुलेट निकाली है, कोई पैलेट निकाले हैं, तो वहाँ भी आपने उसको प्रॉपरली इसको डॉक्यूमेंटेशन करनी है जब आप उसको पुलिस वाले को दे रहे हो। देन प्रेपरेशन ऑफ सेकंड एमएलसी फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ पेशेंट, ये आपने नहीं करना है। दोबारा एक बार एमएलसी हो गया है तो आपने सेकंड एमएलसी नहीं प्रिपेयर करना है। ये भी केसेस आए हैं मेरे पास, द पर्सन प्रिपेयर सेकंड एमएलसी फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द पेशेंट। फैब्रिकेशन ऑफ द वुंड, डॉक्टर खुद ही वुंड बना रहे हैं, फैब्रिकेशन कर रहे हैं, ऑल्दो दिस प्रैक्टिस वेरी लेस। रॉन्ग डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द वुंड फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ पेशेंट, लेसरेटेड को इंसाइज कर दिया, इंसाइज को लेसरेटेड कर दिया, ठीक है, उसको इस तरह से हम उसको रॉन्ग डिस्क्रिप्शन दे रहे हैं, वो विच आर नॉट मैचिंग विद द हिस्ट्री ऑफ दैट केस। ऑल ब्रॉड डेड केसेस शुड बी इन्फॉर्म टू द पुलिस, ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। डेड बॉडी शुड नॉट टू बी गिवन टू द रिलेटिव्स। दिस इज वन केस विच हैज बीन ब्रॉट टू द जीजीएस फॉर द बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन फॉर द एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन, एंड दिस इज पर्टिकुलर दिस केस वॉज कंडक्टेड एट बठिंडा ऑल्सो, एंड द वन ऑफ द डॉक्टर डिस्क्राइब दिस इज अ इनसाइज वुंड 2.5 x 2.5 सेंटीमीटर ऑन द इंटीरियर स्पेक्ट ऑफ राइट लिटल फिंगर मिडल फेलिंग एंड 2.5 x 2.5 सेंटीमीटर इंटीरियर स्पेक्ट ऑफ राइट रिंग फिंगर। दोनों फिंगर की इंजरी के लिए एक इंजरी में डिस्क्राइब कर दिया गया और उस इंजरी को एज इंजरी नंबर 4 एज ए सिंपल नेचर विदाउट एनी इन्वेस्टिगेशन और प्रॉपर क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन। इसमें कुछ नहीं बताया गया कि उसमें कोई और फाइंडिंग साथ में है, ब्लीडिंग है कि नहीं है, फ्रेश ब्लीडिंग है कि नहीं है उसमें। तो यू हैव टू प्रॉपरली क्लिनिकली एग्जामिन और सिंगल इंजरी को डिस्क्राइब करना चाहिए। डिफरेंट फिंगर पे है, राइट लिटल फिंगर पे एक इंजरी है, दूसरी राइट रिंग फिंगर पे एक इंजरी है, तो इट शुड बी डिस्क्राइब सेपरेटली। अब यहाँ पे सेकंड एमएल प्रिपेयर कर दिया नेक्स्ट डॉक्टर ने, उसने भी यही कमिट किया, उसने सुचर बोन लिख दिया, अगेन इंजरी रिमेन सेम ऑन द अंटीरियर स्पेक्ट ऑफ राइट लिटल फिंगर ऑन द मिडल फेलिंग्स, अंटीरियर स्पेक्ट ऑफ राइट रिंग फिंगर मिडल फेलिंग थोड़ा सा उसने ज्यादा कर दिया, बोनी क्रैप्स लिख दिया, क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन कर दिया। अब नॉर्मल मोबिलिटी पर उसने अपनी क्लिनिकल नॉलेज अप्लाई कर दी, पहले वाले ने सीधा सिंपल डिक्लेयर कर दिया, कोई इन्वेस्टिगेशन नहीं की, दूसरे ने कहा कि नहीं इसमें तो फ्रैक्चर है, अब नॉर्मल मोबिलिटी बता दी। तो दिस शुड बी अवॉइड। सो व्हाट इज अवर माई कंक्लूजन, दैट मेडिकोलीगल केसेज हैज टू बी डेल्ट प्रॉपरली फॉलोइंग द लेटेस्ट प्रिवेलिंग गाइडलाइन। सब कुछ बुक्स में दिया है, बुक्स पढ़नी पड़ेंगी। कई बार मेरे पास कुलीग का फोन आता है, डॉक्टर साहब मेरे को पोस्टमार्टम लिखवा दो, मैं कहता हूँ ये बुक्स खोलो, नहीं हमें बुक्स नहीं खोलो, आप लिखवा दो, लिखना कैसे। पीछे मेरे पास एक आया केस, मर्डर का केस, किसी ने मेरे अपने कुलीग ने पूछा, डॉक्टर साहब ने मर्डर का केस था, उसके हेड इंजरी थी, तो कॉज ऑफ डेथ क्या, स्कल खोलो। नहीं डॉक्टर साहब, स्कल तो खोली नहीं, क्लास वर्क को भेजा था, उसने कट लगा दिया, उसने कहा नीचे इंजरी है, आप बता दो कैसे लिखना। तो दिस शुड बी अवॉइडेड, यू शुड रेड दी बुक, सब कुछ दिया हुआ है फ्रेंड्स में। और स्टूडेंट को चाहिए, अभी डॉक्टर प्रमोद अच्छा गाइड कर रहे हैं उनको, कॉन्फ्रेंस के जो सोविनियर है उसमें भी बताया गया है, तो उसको थोड़ा सा स्ट्रेस करें, उसको उसके ऊपर स्ट्रेस करें, पढ़ें उसको, आपको सारे क्वेश्चन के आंसर मिल जाएंगे। इवन इफ ड्यू गाइडलाइंस प्रोसीजर आर नॉट फॉलोड और नॉट अवेलेबल, दीज केसेस पोज नो प्रॉब्लम इफ वन यूज प्रॉपर कॉशन एंड ड्यू केयर एंड अटेंशन। आपको अप्रेहेंसिव नहीं होना है व्हाइल डीलिंग विद देम। प्रॉपर डॉक्यूमेंटेशन क्लिनिकल लोगों के लिए है, डॉक्यूमेंटेशन करना है, कोई भी प्रोसीजर कर रहे हैं उसके बारे में लिखना है आपने कि आपने क्या किया है, कंसेंट लेनी है, प्रोसीजर के बारे में लिखना है, तभी हम फाइनल ओपिनियन दे पाएंगे। टाइमली इंफॉर्मेशन एंड थॉरो एग्जामिनेशन इंक्लूडिंग आर रेलिवेंट इन्वेस्टिगेशन एंड रेफरल्स आर दैट आर नेसेसरी टू सी सच केसेस कंप्लीटेड सक्सेसफुली एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच।
वेरी गुड प्रेजेंटेशन। There is one question in my mind. You are told the first medico-legal examination conducted and nobody can conduct second medico-legal examination. Then if false and fabricated medico-legal examination has been conducted, who is the authority to decide the second medical examination should conduct it?
It's an investigating officer or judicial magistrate. They can, not ask, the civil surgeon. They can ask for the board examination.
No, civil surgeon has authority to decide for
it
second medical.
It is written that the investigating officer is written in the medical manual. The investigating officer or judicial officer can ask for the board examination.
Not the civil surgeon.
No.
Not the SM or civil surgeon.
Very good presentation and quite informative. That what are the mistakes that are committed while performing these types of injury reports And I want to elaborate few things which the UG students there commit when we are saying them to prepare a UG report. They will omit the opinion. They do not give the opinion. So that is very, very important part which is they should have to learn while preparing these medical legal reports. Do not omit this part that you should have to give your opinion in each and every case when you are preparing a medical legal report. As and when the death of that very patient will be there, do not issue a death certificate. Then you should have to inform to the police and then the police will decide what should have to be done. Thank you, sir, so much. And now the session is open for discussion if anyone have got a query.
I just want to ask a question since you are expert in this field, that if a patient, say, girl, unmarried girl of 13 years after rape, but reports to my hospital with pregnancy more than 26 weeks, and she says that she already have had her medical legal examination and all, but now she wants only termination, but she is more than 24 weeks of pregnancy. What should we do?
You have to take direction from High Court. The person has to take direction from High Court. Recently we have terminated the pregnancy of more than 24 weeks after taking direction from High Court.
But there was one case now where they took her pregnancy up to term and then they did the cesarean section. It was very much in the news. So what do you...
Sir, any things you have to take direction from the court if such cases are arise, came to you.
So we should tell the patient to go.
Yeah, definitely.
As madam has rightly said that we are not supposed to direct that you should go to the High Court. We are not here to counsel them, but simply say that we cannot perform. That should be the answer. And one thing I would like to add in this case that it is said that opinions are like wristwatches. Everybody's wristwatch shows different time, but everybody say that my opinion is best. My time is correct. So even if difference of opinion by different doctors are there, they need not to be frightened for anything. So everybody is having its own opinion. So while framing opinion, the first line which you should start while writing, it should be mentioned in my opinion or in our opinion. From that you should start your opinion. And one very important question is history. There is a great confusion whether while doing medical legal examination, history should be recorded or not. Different doctors, they are having different views about that. So basically, history is a very important part, as most of the clinical diseases are diagnosed from the history of the cases. Similarly, history in medical legal cases recorded earlier, the better it is. So how much history should be recorded, that is equally important. So we are not supposed to write down an FIR, just like a police officer. So our should be a brief medical legal history in which we have to record only 5 W's. When, where, by whom, with what, how, and afterward. Afterward means after the incident, where did you go? Whether you go to the police station, to your home, to the hospital. 6 lines are more than enough in regarding the history of the case. Thank you.
Dr. Buller, want to ask a question, please?
I just want to add a little this applicability with your MLR or PMR, I mean the medical legal report, what Dr. Joshi, you have missed, the doctor who has done this examination or anything, I mean, he is supposed to sign the report, and now as per newspaper reports, which is in my mobile, cook nahi chalegi road. It was a report, cook nahi chalegi, karne padenge puri tasveer. So doctor is supposed to sign complete with full name and even with your PMC number, and I will add one thing, write down your mobile number also, so that later on it is easy to contact the authorities, the authority to you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, one from our audience today.
Sir, I have one question that I have been at the government service in 3 years.
Please give me my mic.
Sir, I am in government service since 3 years. I used to hear that before there was a practice that whenever an MLC case comes to hospital, they used to get a FI or a DDR number done from the police station also.
Is there any kind of loss? No need. You have to do the MLC as early as possible and inform the police accordingly.
Any other queries from medical officer?
In which we are supposed to write an MLR, like if an injury is around 50 days, 20 days, 30 days old, is there a time frame?
There's no time limit, sir. I have mentioned, there's no time limit.
Right, sir. Thank you.
Dr. Harish from Agroha.
Sir, I had a doubt. You have mentioned that the maximum limit for record keeping in various medico-legal cases is till the disposal of the case. But in the second session...
it's a 12 year.
Yes.
It's controversial, so, but I think it's, in my opinion, this should be there.
But sir, in many of the, in present scenario, practically, if you are talking about the practicality of the issue, in most of the cases, we are not aware whether it is disposed of, whether it is in sub judice. So how can we take our
That is why I think I cannot say when whether the case is in sub judice or not. So you have to take, you have to preserve the medical legal record for indefinite period. It's not mentioned anywhere.
I will just give one example. I worked in Agroha in 2004, and I just 2 months back I got call from the police station that Fatehabad B doctor sahab aapka summon hai. Aur first time ye summon aa raha hai 2004 ka. So you can imagine that how long we should preserve the medico-legal record. 2004 postmortem.
For preservation of record are there in different states. But from my practical experience, I can say that when I joined GMC Amritsar in January 85, from that time till today, our record is there. We have not destroyed the record.
And presentation over there. So many questions we have got from the audience. Thank you, Dr. Rajiv Joshi, sir, for giving us so much informative lecture. Thank you.
Sir, to give a memento as a token of remembrance to Dr. R.C. Garg. Dr. Puneet from PIMS. And Dr. Rajendra Khuladi from Biganer.
He is HOD, Government Medical College, Amritsar. Everybody knows he is a good teacher. He knew his subject very well. And he is, most of us, we got everything from Dr. Shobhs, sir. Now he is going to present the case, present the PPT. Thank you.
Today I have been given the topic, that is sample collection for DNA profiling. What are the practical specs? How we have to approach, how to have to collect the samples? I have seen that many times cases of DNA fingerprinting sent to us by the medical officer with the endorsement of the civil surgeon, mentioning that as the DNA facilities are not available in our institution, so these cases are sent to you for DNA fingerprinting. I want to tell you that as far as DNA fingerprinting is concerned, we are not doing DNA fingerprinting. We are simply collecting the samples. So samples for DNA can be collected anywhere by anyone. It is as simple as taking the blood for pathological or biochemistry investigations, filling the form, taking the fees, then subjecting the sample for test. It is just like
those laboratories. But here, because there is a horror in the mind of the medical officer, something may not happen while doing the sample collection for DNA. As far as we people are concerned, the Punjab government has not issued any instruction to us where to send these samples. Neither we don't know whether Punjab is having any laboratory for DNA fingerprinting or not. Recently somebody told me that yes, a laboratory has been established, but we did not get any surplus, frankly. And even I don't know where the other people, they are sending the samples for DNA profiling. So I am telling my experience, the practical aspect which we are doing at GMC Amritsar. Because